all karma, all action is for the actor. And if the actor is a desirous actor, then all action just leads to a continuation of the cycle of desire. You look at your karma and the karma phal. Does any karma phal ever mean a full stop? Is any result ever so very satisfying that it is final?
No.
So karma and karma phal are a continuity, they are a cycle, and they are a cycle of ignorance. The doer, the actor behind the karma, the action, keeps feeling that action will lead to liberation. Now action cannot lead to liberation. Action emanating from the actor, that is the ego, the I tendency, can never lead to liberation, because the very beginning is flawed. The beginning itself is in loneliness. The beginning itself is in incompleteness. The results of such beginnings cannot be auspicious. When you start from a wrong place, then you cannot reach a right place. That sounds counterintuitive, because we do see this happening in the world, right? You are standing at some undesirable place, and from there you can reach a desirable place. But in the domain of truth, there is no interdimensional ladder. A wrong place is a wrong dimension. You will keep moving in that dimension. Starting from a wrong center, from a wrong place, you will keep moving in a space that is wrong. In that space, you can travel far and wide. The space of the ego too is an infinite space. Manakash, that too is infinite, just like the truth. The space of imagination is also very infinite. You can keep roaming there all your life, but you will never be able to go beyond that space. It's like walking inside a closed room. You can keep walking all your life, but that will not take you out of the room. So, within the room is action, within the room is the result of the action. Then out of the result of the action, there is more action. Then again more action, then again more action, again more action, and all of that within the room, in the hope of getting out of the room. That is not going to happen. That is just not going to happen. What is the room? The tendency to act itself is the room. You do not run inside the room. The running itself defines the room. Stop running and the room disappears. The question that would be arising within you is, I am stuck inside that room. Now how do I come out of that room? You are stuck inside that room because you are running inside that room. Karma, karma phal, action, more action, more running, more desires, more running, more action. The running is the room. Stop and you will find there is no room. The dimension has changed. You are now in free space. Stop. More action will not take you out of action. More effort will not lead to effortlessness. More desires will not lead to desirelessness.
In your one desire, you can it be your desirelessness in desire itself?
No, not even that. That is the final trap. That is the final trap in which most seekers and gurus are caught. I will give you desirelessness. Impossible. I'll give you the experience of desirelessness. even more impossible. I'll give you the experience of truth. Impossibly impossible.
And what about mumukshutva?
Mumukshutva means seeing the futility of desire. The futility of desire. Now, seeing the futility of desire is not the same as desiring the end of desire or desiring the futility of desire. Seeing is effortless. Desiring is effort. There is a great deal of difference between action and realization. Don't confuse the two. Mumukshutva is realization, not further action. Mumukshutva is to see that I'm stuck. And it's no good trying anymore because I have anyway been trying since the beginning of time.
Born because of the love karma?
Yes.
To my parents?
Yes. Good. But your death will not be due to law of karma. I'm talking of real death. Real death cannot happen due to karma. Real death happens when you see the fallacy of karma, when you see the falseness of all karma. Then there is real death. So you are born so that you may totally die. People keep asking me, what is the purpose of life? The purpose of life is total death. That is the only purpose of life. Total death. That is why you have all those stories, that even after dying, he was roaming here and there. Have you heard of these stories?
Yes.
But we believe as if something really is roaming here and there. And we get scared and we do all kinds of rituals and rites. And we say it is for Atma Shanti. First of all, the phrase is foolish. As if Atma is ever Ashant. But yes, symbolically, what those stories indicate has substance. Because you have not totally died, you are still there. Of course, you are not there in space-time. You are not there as some material roaming here and there. But you are still there.
The eye tendency
is still there.
Waiting for a body?
Waiting for something. See, the eye tendency is so thirsty, it can get attached to anything. It can get attached to soil, to body, to idea, to imagination. Don't you see that happening with you?
Yeah.
What all do you get attached to?
Gem.
Just about everything. Whatever you can think of is a possible object of attachment.
So, the eye tendency of Atman is present even in plants.
Don't talk of something outside of you, because plants as you see them are a result of your eye tendency. So, don't talk of stuff here and there. Yes, theoretically what you are saying is correct. It can get associated to plants, it can get associated even with a rock or air. Yes, that is possible. But it's useless to talk of all of these things. One has to just look at his life as it is right now and see the eye tendency in action. It's pointless asking whether a rock has I tendency and hence an ego? And those questions do come. Does a rock have ego? Pointless question. First of all, you look at how the ego operates in your daily life. That is far more important.
So this I tendency is universal, it's like it's happening to everybody.
Yes.
And when the realized one knows this, so his I tendency drops out. It should it continue?
His I tendency gets fulfilled. Fulfilled. That is what you call as dropping of I.
But still it continues in other people.
Yes, yes.
So death is not predetermined.
It is predetermined because it is decided in advance that once the body reaches a certain age, the cells will become weak and they will not be able to anymore remain united with the I tendency. But that also means that as science advances, your cells can be manipulated to stay in contact with I for longer and longer periods of time. In fact, it is possible that you can have a physical configuration that remains attached to I almost endlessly. But that would not mean immortality. Even if you will live for 2000 years, you will live as a lonely being. Even if you are living for 10,000 years, you are still living an unfulfilled life. That is not immortality. Immortality is to feel so fulfilled that you are not counting years anymore. You are not asking, am I going to die at 50 or 80? That is immortality. When you are no more bothered about time, then you are immortal. This is seeing, this that is happening right now. This listening is seeing. You see how you are immersed in listening? This is seeing. This total devotion to the truth. I want to know, this is seeing.
So death in an accident is the law of karma combined for everybody?
Yes, it is the law of karma. You see, accidentally you can take a compound and put it on fire and it splits. When you are looking at the decomposition of compounds, you are actually studying your own decomposition.
This karma is done by the body.
The body becomes a medium. All karma is initiated by the unfulfilled I tendency.
I came to know about the camp by a Facebook page group. So, me coming here is due to seeing, becoming a member of seeing of that, or it is destined, or it would have come automatically. I would have come.
You look at something. That something is not objective. That something is given a shape, a meaning by your I tendency. You getting it? You could either come here because you interpreted the information in a particular way, or you could come here because you read of it and then you surrendered to the event. You said, I look at it and I don't even have to apply my mind. I see that there is something of the truth here. I face many an obstacles in going, but still I'll go. Now you are letting action happen without the I tendency. Now you are acting without the actor. Or you could have said going there would give me that kind of benefit, this kind of benefit. Then you are performing karma.
Can be anything.
Karma is always associated with desire. That is why to give you pure karma, Krishna talks of nishkam karma. Karma without the expectation of karma phal. Then you are acting without the actor.
Vedas or Upanishad says that there was initially there was no world, skies,
yes.
So nothing was there except the word Om, and from that Om word vibration everything got created. So can you
even Om is not the first one. Even Om comes from a total emptiness. There is the bindu, then there is the nad. Om is the nad. And before the nad, there is just a point. Point means not even space. Not even space. So nothing. Nothing as we can know of. Nothing that we may talk of. Nothing that is existing as per our definitions of existence. So when we say nothing, we mean nothing as per our mind. Or you could say everything. Because only from that great everything at another level can everything at this level arise. So it depends on how you want to put it verbally. You could say nothing. You are right. You could say everything. You are again right.
So I tendencies differ because of conditioning.
I tendency doesn't differ. I tendency is the same. The objects that the I tendency gets circumstantially attached to, they differ. And the object that you are currently associated with guides the next object that you would be associated with. But in this craving for association and subsequent association, the tendency to get attached is the same.